Today on the show, we're going to be taking a look at the origin and history of Disney's DuckTales, so stay tuned. On September 18th, 1987, Disney Television Animation brought to us a series and theme song that would burn itself into the minds of children the world over. DuckTales is notable for being the first Disney animated television series to be produced for syndication and paved the way for Chip 'n Dale Rescue Rangers, Tailspin, Darkwing Duck, and Goof Troop. The 1987-1988 season of DuckTales consisted of 65 episodes, which was a standard length for a Disney TV series, as well as the standard length of many first seasons of the 1990s-era TV shows. The series proved so popular that Disney produced a 74-minute animated movie on August 3, 1990, entitled DuckTales the Movie, Treasure of the Lost Lamp. It was the first film produced by Disney Toon Studios, and the first to have a theatrical release as well. The series and film follow the exploits of Scrooge McDuck with his nephews Huey, Dewey, and Louie, as well as family friend Webby, her grandmother and Scrooge's maid Mrs. Beakley, Launchpad McQuack, and Scrooge's butler Duckworth. In the series canon, Donald Duck originally had custody of his nephews. Without explanation as to what happened to their mother or father, Donald eventually left Duckburg for a time to join the Navy, leaving his nephews in the care of his wealthy Uncle Scrooge. Donald made few appearances in the animated series. Scrooge McDuck made his first named appearance in Christmas on Bear Mountain in December of 1947. The story is featured in a Donald Duck comic by Carl Banks, first published in Dell Comics 4 Color Comics, number 178. Scrooge's relatives other than Donald and the triplets include his mother Downey O'Drake, his father Fergus McDuck, his sisters Hortense, which was the triplets' grandmother, and Matilda McDuck, his brother Gideon McDuck, and half-brother Rumpus McFowl. His grandfather was Titus McDuck. Scrooge also has a nephew other than Donald named Gladstone Gander, and a niece, Della Duck, who was the mother of Huey, Dewey, and Louie, and twin sister of Donald. Scrooge is also somehow related to the scientist Ludwig von Drake. According to the Dutch Disney comic 80 is Prachtig, Della was one of the first female pilots and eventually became an astronaut, so she left her children with her brother just before she left for a space trip. In the 1942 cartoon The New Spirit, the nephews were listed as being adopted by Donald, which has been carried over into the 2017 reboot series. In the 1938 comic strip, Donald's Nephews, it was said the triplets put a firecracker under their father's seat, and they had to stay with their uncle Donald until he recovered. The triplets' father made his first physical appearance in Mark Warden's illustrated version of Carl Banks' 1950s Duck Family Tree. In the Disney comic parody Return to Duckburg Place, Daffy Duck was said to be the nephew's father. Donald also has a son with Daisy Duck, who appeared in the 1959 cartoon short How to Have an Accident at Work, but never appears in any animated shorts or in DuckTales since. Scrooge McDuck was first voiced by Dallas McKinnon in 1960, then by Bill Thompson in Scrooge McDuck and Money before eventually being voiced by actor Alan Young from 1974 to 2016. Young was the first actor to voice Scrooge with an authentic Scottish accent. His first voice appearance as Scrooge was in an adaptation of Dickens' Christmas Carol performed by the Walt Disney Players. This version of A Christmas Carol was an album written and conceived of by Alan Young and Alan Dinehart. It would go on to inspire the 1983 classic Mickey's Christmas Carol, which also featured Alan Young as Scrooge. In the series DuckTales, the only episodes that did not feature Scrooge McDuck were Super Do, Sir Gyro Degearloose, and Launchpad Civil War. Scrooge is known as the wealthiest duck in the world, and his main rival is that of the second richest duck in the world, Flintheart Glomgold, and followed closely behind by John D. Rocker Duck. Scrooge received his fortune through years of hard work, well-utilized intelligence, honesty, perseverance, and extreme thriftiness. He's an adventurer and an opportunist. Scrooge worked his way up the financial ladder from humble immigrant roots. He spent his youth in Glasgow, Scotland, where he made a living shining boots, which is how he earned his number one dime. Scrooge's number one dime originated from American Howard Rocker Duck, who tossed pocket change to some playing children while touring through Glasgow. Scrooge's sister Matilda caught the dime and gave it to her father, Fergus McDuck. Fergus then gave the dime to his son Scrooge's friend Bert, the ditch digger. Fergus asked Bert to go to Scrooge's street shoe shine business to shine his extra dirty boots. Getting paid with the worthless American coin after his hard work, Scrooge decided to be smarter than the smarties and tougher than the toughies, and make his money square. For a long period of time after gaining his extensive wealth, Scrooge practically lived alone, and had little contact with his family. This would partially play into his bitterness, though things would slowly change as he opened himself up to his nephews, Donald, Huey, Dewey, and Louie. Scrooge would grow increasingly more compassionate as he spent more time with his nephews, going as far as to regularly invite them on his international treasure hunts as partners and loyal sidekicks. Scrooge's age was only given one time in the 1955 one-page comic, What an Occasion, from the issue Uncle Scrooge No. 12, in which he celebrates his 75th birthday. In 1970, it was stated that Scrooge was born in 1897, making him 73 years old. But in The Life and Times of Scrooge McDuck, he celebrated his 10th birthday in 1877, making him 80 years old at the time it was published. In DuckTales the movie Treasure of the Lost Lamp, his age is placed under 80 years old. Huey, Dewey, and Louie are noted for having both identical appearances and personalities in most appearances, with the three sometimes shown as finishing each other's sentences as a running joke. Huey is the oldest of the triplets, and most responsible, shown in each incarnation to wear a red shirt and hat. Dewey is the middle child of the three, and tries more so than the others to stand out, and can be seen wearing a blue shirt and hat. Louie is the youngest, and therefore lazier than the others, as to not draw as much attention to himself, and can be seen wearing a green shirt and hat. In each incarnation, they are usually portrayed as being 10 years old or younger, while in Quack Pack, the sequel series to DuckTales, they have moved back in with their Uncle Donald, and are teenagers. Scrooge, Donald, and the triplets all live in the city of Duckburg in the state of Calisoda. Created by Al Taliaferro, an artist for Disney's Silly Symphonies comic strip, via a memo dated February 5, 1937, the triplets were actually inspired by Mickey Mouse's nephews, Morty and Ferdy Fieldmouse. The triplets made their debut in comic strip form on October 17, 1937, and then in animated form in April 15, 1938. Their names were devised by Disney gag man Dana Cody, who was inspired by the names of Huey Long, Thomas Dewey, and Louis Schmidt, animators at the Disney Studios in the 1930s and 40s. The triplets' full names were given in the series Quack Pack as Hubert, Deuteronomy, and Louis Duck. It's in this series they were given more distinct personalities. Huey was the ladies' man, Dewey was the computer whiz, and Louie the comic book geek. A few of the early comics depict a fourth nephew due to artist error, jokingly referred to as Fooey, the nephew's long-lost brother. DuckTales' second season added new characters to the mix. Two of those characters became a part of the main cast, such as Fenton Crackshell, who would later become Gizmo Duck, and Bubba the Cave Duck. The series also starred Launchpad McQuack, a lovable doofus and pilot of the series who often acts as an older brother to the triplets and faithful sidekick to Uncle Scrooge. He later went on to co-star in Disney's Darkwing Duck as DW's sidekick. Launchpad is portrayed as fiercely protective of the triplets and Webby, to the point that his goofiness takes a back seat to his responsibility to the kids. Launchpad's first appearance was in the third part of the pilot episode, The Treasure of the Golden Suns, where he's hired by Gyro and Scrooge to fly Gyro's newest helicopter. When Launchpad met the legendary crime fighter Darkwing Duck, he revealed that he was Darkwing's number one fan and offered to be the crime fighter's sidekick. At the time, Darkwing declared that he was a loner as a superhero and didn't need any help. After Darkwing's adopted daughter Goslin had been kidnapped by Taurus Bulba, Darkwing's first real enemy, Launchpad revealed his newest plan, the Thunderquack, which they used to invade Bulba's airship and rescue Goslin. The Thunderquack served as Darkwing's personal plane after Darkwing dubbed Launchpad his true sidekick. In 1992, Huey, Dewey, and Louie appeared in the Drug Prevention TV special, which was simulcast on the top three networks of CBS, NBC, and ABC, entitled Cartoon All-Stars to the Rescue. The triplets and Webby were voiced by Russie Taylor during the show's broadcast history and theatrical film. Launchpad was voiced by Terry McGovern. Miss Beakley was voiced by Joan Gerber. Duckworth was voiced by Chuck McCann. Gyro was voiced by Hal Smith. Fenton Crackshell and Gizmo Duck were both voiced by Hamilton Camp. Donald Duck has been voiced by Tony Anselmo since 1985, after apprenticing under Clarence Nash for 3 years before taking over the role. The main villains of the series and movie were Magica Dispel and Ma Beagle, voiced by June Foray, Flintheart Glomgold, voiced by Hal Smith, Murloc the Magician, voiced by Christopher Lloyd, Dijon, voiced by Richard Libertini, and The Beagle Boys, which were all voiced by various cast members. Big Time Beagle and Baggy Beagle were voiced by Frank Welker. Burger Beagle and Baggy Beagle were voiced by Chuck McCann. Bank Job Beagle was voiced by Peter Cullen. Babyface Beagle was voiced by Terry McGovern. Bugle Beagle, voiced by Brian Cummings. And Megabyte Beagle, voiced by Don Messick. That does it for this video, guys. If you want a part 2, which focuses on the 2017 reboot series, let me know in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on future videos. I'm Shannon for Comageddon TV, the only place on YouTube where all geek culture collides. Take care, my friends. Life is like a hurricane.